This is Oklahoma, as you've seen already so far today. Just in the last 30 seconds to minutes, we have seen rapid changes with this storm. But if you're in Medicine Park, you're in the direct path of this tornado-warned storm. It has produced a tornado at one time earlier today. No report right now if we do have another one, but we are closely monitoring it, and you can still see that inflow notch, this area right here is where we're going to be watching closely as this storm lifts off to the northeast. This is a particularly dangerous tornado situation. If you are outside, you need to be seeking shelter right now. When we see a storm cycle, the circulation that's dying is going to be to the south. The circulation that's starting to ramp up and reorganize is going to be farther off to the north. If this happens, Chatty, you're going to be very, very near this tornado warm storm as it pushes through you. And once again, this is a particularly dangerous situation as far as the tornado goes. It has been confirmed. Right now, we don't know if it's still on the ground or not. We haven't seen any reports really within the last 4 to 5 minutes, but things can be changing very quickly. And since this is an environment that hasn't been tapped into just yet this evening, the tornado threat is still going to remain an issue for the next hour to 2 hours. Jefferson and Stevens counties, first thing today, you're seeing lightning, you're seeing the rain, but we're also watching those winds. Earlier this morning, we were still under freeze watches. Those have since been canceled and replaced by freeze warnings. So all of Texoma and those freeze warnings and much of Oklahoma. The AC, though, probably where you want to be and for a couple of days. High pressure still in the driver's seat. And wait for it. Here we go. We're doing it all over again today, feeling close to 112. The best chance for rain will be Wednesday night into early Thursday morning, and we could see some locally heavy amounts, which means flooding also going to be a little bit of a concern. The humidity, yikes, quite literally going to be sticking with us. I just got back from vacation. I can't be faulted for this. We're live this morning at Gore and 4th Street. Thankfully, I didn't almost get hit by that bus. But if you were out there, hopefully you weren't in the road, because that's never a good idea. We're not dealing with rain for the most part first thing this morning, but some of us are mainly off to the east, off to the southeast. More of us are going to be dealing with rain later on tonight. Not nearly as widespread as we saw yesterday. Most of that rain now across eastern Oklahoma and much of North Texas, but we're watching a batch off in northern Oklahoma that's trying to dive off to the south. That's not here just yet, but a few showers remain between Duncan and Waurika. Those are lifting off to the north and northeast. Velma saw a few showers earlier today. And here's the big picture. This upper level low continues to spin like a top. It's bringing in all of that moisture from the southwest to the northeast. And we're seeing more moisture wrapping around on the left side of this low. That's going to be helping our storm chances later on today, really the next 24 hours. This morning into this afternoon, the best chance for rain stays off to the east, stays off to the southeast. Most of us are quiet, so keep in mind the rain gear not necessary for everyone throughout the first part of our day. Then later on tonight, mainly after about 4 o'clock, we're going to start to see some storms moving in from the north. We could also see a few more storms staying out to the east and off to the southeast. These could be strong at times. We're talking some gusty winds, some small hail. The highest threat for the strongest of storms stays well to the north of I-40 later on tonight, but some of these storm chances could linger into early Wednesday morning. Right now, things are cool. Quiet here from our Duncan Regional Hospital Tower Cam, seeing mostly cloudy skies, 71 degrees right now with a southeast wind around 7 miles an hour. 88 today in Duncan, 90 in Lawton, 91 in Altus. More 90s, more 80s for North Texas. Then overnight, some upper 60s, some low 70s. We're going to see those storm chances lingering into early Wednesday morning. Then we take a break as far as those storm chances go on Thursday. More storms arrive Friday, Saturday, Sunday, and Monday. But all of those chances are low, and most of them will be occurring at night. So, hey, don't cancel those outdoor plans right now. They look to be just fine. And for August, we're talking 90s. Not too bad. I know we're still going to heat up at some point this month.
Right.
But we've been very cool the last couple weeks, and we'll keep running with it.
Wow, that's so nice.
A full week of 90s on there.
No triple digits.
All right. Thanks.